I feel like I look like a sexy Tina.
How many times has he said, it's my birthday today, I'll punch him?
I'll punch him!
Don't go and buy a banana! You got a banana! Okay, but why does it look like I just got pulled over by the police and I'm just like sitting here like waiting to get a ticket? Like,
I'm sorry, excuse me, officer, your ticket can wait. I have to do my intro.
I didn't get pulled over, I swear. It's like this blue light over here that's like casting this weird, I just got pulled over thumbnail. Like, she had bad bits and she don't even know it. Good morning, my loves. Welcome back to today's vlog, which today's vlog is super special because it's actually my fiance's birthday today. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but I am in a dark parking lot at night by myself without my fiance on his birthday. So I know that you have a lot of questions, and same.
I don't know how I ended up here.
What is my life?
But honestly, this is what's been going on. I didn't vlog any second of today, which is kind of crazy because I love talking to you guys, but I just wanted the entire day to be my fiance's day, right? And so I was asking him up like weeks in advance prior to this, like 2 weeks in advance. I was like, what do you want to do, babe? Is this something that requires special planning? Like, should we book a trip somewhere? Should we, you know, ride a hot air balloon? I love how this is like my thought process now. And he was like, honestly, I don't really want to do any of those. And I was like, well, what else do you want to do? Like, do you want to go to like Chinatown? Which sounds racist, but
he just really enjoys Chinatown.
So it's not like a racist, like he loves Arcadia. It's not, no. And so I was like, what do you want to do? Like, what do you want for your birthday? And I was just kind of asking him all these questions. And up until yesterday, he was like, I don't know what I want to do. I don't think I want to do anything. And then today, this morning, we woke up and he goes, babe, I know what I want to do for my birthday. And I started getting immense anxiety and stress because I'm like, God, he's gonna be like, I want to go skydiving, and then I'm gonna have to call like 25 different companies and try to find out like if we could get in for a skydiving trip today. And he goes, I want to sit at home and I want to watch movies. And I was like, what? And he was like, I want to Postmates food and I want to like really watch a movie. So when I say like really watch a movie, just like to preface things, I feel like my fiance and I are both busy bees. Like, we're both busy bodies is what a lot of people call us, but he's the more productive version, like the one that you would actually imagine when you hear the word busy bee. And I'm like the more
easily distracted, constantly wants to do stupid
busy bee, right? So my fiance is the type when like I play a movie and it's on the TV, he'll do his work, he'll answer respond to emails, he'll like do his thing. But I'm the type where if you put on a movie, I'm like, all of a sudden I want to organize my makeup drawer, all of a sudden I want to do the dishes. Like, I just get super distracted by these things where I'm like editing. And so we've never, and like, I want to say,
God, I don't know if I'm being dramatic,
maybe like a year and a half, we've never both sat down to like truly watch a movie. When's the last time we went to a movie theater? Because the last time we went to a movie theater, we realized that we were both getting antsy, like angsty, as the movie was going on, because we were just both like, I felt like I needed to do
something with my body.
Like, I like to like move around during a movie. Like, my butt gets sore. I feel like I'm on an airplane when I'm at the movie theater. And so we just haven't been like watching movies. And he was like, I just want to try it today. So I guess for my fiance, it's more of like maybe a guilt thing. He like wants to be productive. For me, it's more like a distraction thing. He's like, I don't want to do anything but watch movies today. So we've been watching nonstop movies since the minute that we woke up until like 7:30. So my brain is mush at this point, and I still need to get him a birthday gift. So let me explain. The past couple of days, I've been asking him like, what do you want for your birthday? What do you want for your birthday? And he's like, no, I don't want anything. Like, you're gonna buy me something and I'm gonna have to return it because like, I don't want Gucci shoes. Like, I'm not like that. I don't want a Balenciaga hoodie. Like, I just like don't want that. And my fiance is the type where if he feels like he needs something in his life, he gets it. Like, he just gets it. Like, he doesn't ask me. He doesn't like wait for it to go on sale. Like, he's like, oh, I see the value in this product and it will enhance my life, I must purchase it right now while I am thinking about it, right? And so I feel like he doesn't like to have a lot of things, but he also doesn't like wait to have something. So it's really hard to catch him at a point where like it's his birthday and he was like trying to think of something to get. So I was like, oh, I want to get him something. And I was like looking online, and then he'd be like, no, don't give me anything. And it's crazy because I couldn't order anything in advance because we have like joint accounts, but I also have like my own account. He has access to all of them just to see like how I spend my money, because he's really good with like budgeting and like finance stuff, and
I suck.
And so we just mapped out a future financial plan for my life as well. And then he was like, okay, in order to do this, you must save this, invest this, and spend this much in a month. And so I have like a very strict budget, and as long as I stay within my budget, it's okay. But I need him to like
fact check me, okay?
He sees all of those, right? And so I was like, if I get it early, I know he's gonna see it and be like, oh babe, like why did you spend so much money at Apple for example? And then I'd have to make up some stupid ass lie and he wasn't gonna believe it. So I just waited up until now. It's 7:30 and I snuck out, and now I'm in the mall parking lot because all day today I kept trying to get out and he was like, no, it's fine. Like I kept trying to go to the grocery store. I was like, oh, I need to go to the grocery store because I need to pick up some apples. I don't want to like pause the movie. It's my birthday. Like literally, how many times has he said, it's my birthday today? I'll punch him.
I'll punch him.
And so I was like, okay, damn it. And then I had a genius idea. Sure, you can prevent me from getting apples because it's your birthday. Sure, you can say, babe, don't order it. Don't go and buy a banana. You got a banana. And so I'm like, fine, it's your birthday. So I've been like, just kind of like, okay, Postmating all this fruit that I don't really crave. Then I was like, wait a second. What is one thing a guy cannot say no to? Because he has no idea what he's talking about. And I said, babe,
I just started my period.
And Postmates doesn't have the pads that I want. And he goes, oh, okay, let's pause the movie. And I'm technically supposed to be at Target buying pads right now, but I'm at the mall because I'm about to go to Apple. I'm so annoying. I have the big iPad Pro, which you guys see me use all the time. And that's one thing that I don't go a day without using. And I feel like my fiance is getting slightly more digital, but he has like 3 journals, right? And they're not like journaling journals, but like he has one for to-dos, he has one for goals, and then he has another one for like just his work stuff, right? And so I was like, I feel like it's really dumb to have like 3 separate journals, and I feel like maybe you should go more digital. And I kept trying to convince him to get an iPad because it greatly enhanced my life. And he was like, well, it's like $1,000. I don't want to get it. I don't think I need it. Maybe I'll just get like the small iPad. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go buy him an iPad and surprise him, because I realized in the past I would buy him these things that I thought were fun and that I thought that like would be like, because when I think about my birthday, I think about like getting gifts that are fun that I wouldn't buy myself. Like I'd be like, oh,
can you buy me this totally useless expensive thing?
For example, like a purse. Like that's totally useless expensive thing, but it makes somebody so happy if they like purses. So I thought my fiance was the same. So I would buy him these like useless things that were just like very cool and like I thought would bring him excitement. But he truly, I think he appreciates gifts that make his life more productive. I don't know. Why does he sound like such a crazy like teacher dictator?
He's not.
I'm just gonna try to get him the most productive gift that I can think about. I brought this bag so that when I bring it back into the house, I don't know if I should like gift wrap it. He doesn't really like gift wrap. He thinks it's like a waste of paper, so I'm not entirely sure. God, he's such a weird guy to shop for. So I'm gonna go into the mall. I'm gonna go into Apple. It's about, I wanna say like an hour before closing, so we gotta hurry it up. I hope they have it in stock. And I'm gonna get him the Apple Pencil, and it's gonna be a blast, okay? Mission birthday, let's go. I feel like I'm on Mission Impossible. And I'm wearing sweatpants today, guys. Okay, I just realized the biggest fuck up of my life. I forgot my freaking wallet at home. I forgot my wallet at home, okay. So I'm hoping that Apple takes Apple Pay, because I don't have my ID either, and that would be the most ironic thing of life if Apple was like, sorry, we don't take Apple Pay, so. This is so cool. They have baby toys and diapers in a vending machine. Okay, so I just got him Apple and they take Apple Pay. I got him a keyboard, I got him an Apple Pencil, and I got him an iPad. So I hope he likes it. If he doesn't like it, I mean, Apple is really good with their returns, but hopefully he loves it and hopefully
it changes his life for the better.
Which sounds so crazy, because I was like literally telling the Apple person, oh, I got an iPad Pro and it changed my life, because I used to carry around these, like, I don't know if you guys have been watching me since then, but prior to that, I would carry around these thick journals. And I would go through, I want to say like 5 journals every 2 months, and they were like $20 each. Oh, it's getting dark, sorry, I'm getting like kind of creeped out. I would carry around like 5 journals each or something, I forget, it was something so ridiculous, and this just simplified my life. And you guys know I'm not like the most organized person, but it's like the only thing that has somewhat helped me become organized. So I was like, yeah. So I was telling the Apple person, yeah, like the iPad Pro changed my life. And then I was like, wait, that sounds like the most millennial, stupid 2019. Oh, this iPad changed my life. I'm like so paranoid at night in parking garages. Okay, let's go home and surprise him.
Thank you.
20? Yeah. You know how you said you didn't want me to buy you anything for your birthday?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't. You know what they say about keeping a relationship alive. I am no longer Stephanie Sue. I am E-Girl Coachella Thoughty Instagram Baddie. I actually have a surprise for you under this. You know what they say about
trench coats on birthday.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Don't do it. I don't understand.
You all wondered how therapy is going. It's going great. It's okay. A swimsuit.
Okay.
It's
just oh my god, it's hairy.
Hold on. I got you a real present.
I said I was gonna go buy some pads. And I didn't lie.
Because I bought you an iPad!
Oh my god.
And I bought you a keyboard! Before you said, I don't need it, I don't want it, I'm gonna return it. Just try using it. I said okay. If he opens it, he tries using it.
Also, I'm not gonna be paying any bills this month.
I feel like I look like a sexy Tina. Stephanie was found wigless and careerless because sexy Tina took over her show.
What about this?
No. Oh, I don't have my pants on. So how's your birthday so far? Tell them
this is the best.
I think we gotta go back to the therapy.
Okay, honestly, I thought it looked really good, but whatever. Okay, so my fiance is setting up his iPad, using it, but I want to try something. So I ordered this burger a little bit earlier today, so I hope it's still good. And you guys know how the Impossible Burger, they made one from Burger King called the Impossible Burger, which is a vegan burger. No, it's a vegetarian. It has no meat in the patty, and it's supposed to be like the best thing ever. We tried it from Umami. I feel like it's really, really good alternative. What did we say about it? It doesn't really taste like meat, right? But this lit place called Mendocino Farms, they have their own version of the Impossible Burger called Burger Queen.
Is it new?
Yeah, and it's called Burger Queen.
Burger Queen?
Yeah, because Burger King came out with their own Impossible Burger, so I'm gonna try it. It looks like this. It looks like...
What happened to the bun? Got a little over-tanned.
What happened to the meat patty?
Can I try? You made it look so good.
It tastes like Burger King. They use the same sauce as Burger King, I believe.
Flavor?
Yeah.
Really good.
Uh-huh.
The meat part?
Mm-hmm.
I wish it's a little more texture. I feel like it kind of melts a little. Right? Like, I didn't even get to bite it. It's all melted.
It's really thin, too. Mm-hmm. I think they just get the meat from Impossible Burger because when we had the Impossible Burger from Umami, which is the same company, Impossible is like the burger company that supplies these vegan meat. But I feel like Umami did it better. I think their burger patty was thick and it was like juicy. Yeah. This one's just kind of like a flat chicken patty almost. She's a burger queen, you know?
Dancing with you.
Feel the beer. Of the burger
queen. Ooh.
You can eat, having the time of our lives.
Oh.
Ooh, see that burger, watch it. I was gonna say pulse. Well, I can only say that because I'm eating an Impossible Burger right now.
Tiger.
I'm gonna go finish this up. We gotta go feed the dogs. It's his birthday, but responsibilities still live on. The dogs have been so lazy because we've been so lazy today. They've just been hanging out on the bottom cushions of the sofa while we've been watching movies, so let's go feed them. Oh my gosh, welcome to the laziest day of my mother freaking life, bitch. So my fiance and I have been pretty much going back to watching movies, eating some cake, watching some more movies. I decided now is the time. What I look like is why. Oh my god, there's three of me looking so shitty right now. Wait, there's two. That was creepy. I think I'm gonna try to clean up all of this because I really hate going to sleep with like a shitty, what do you call this? Like a shitty reset. So I just swiped all the floors with the Swiffer sweeper. And now I'm gonna get into kind of organizing all of this shit. Oh, should I do this? I mean, this is so bad. I think maybe I'm gonna try to reorganize this really quickly in the span of 30 minutes, and I'll see you guys after, because this is the before. This is the before. I mean, this one's not as bad. This one's the before. Dun 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 dun. Okay, sorry. I'm kind of whispering right now, she says, while she's screaming, because we have some people over to install a giant wall installation of mirrors for a gym and tomorrow's vlog, or today's vlog, but you guys are gonna see it tomorrow. First, let me show you guys what's going on in these drawers. I've got my skincare drawer here, which is where I used to put all my skincare stuff. Okay, wait. You guys remember how messy this was, right? And I think it's because I used to get these containers were in there, these low ones. And so when you put anything like this in there, it would just get so messy because it just didn't have like the sides that came up. And so now I have these plastic boxes in here. And so these are from the pink room. They're just like for organization and I stuck them in here. And these are amazing. These acne patches from Amazon, I believe, the cover patch, they work amazing. And then I've got some more serums and then I've got a bunch of like container masks. And then these are like just PR packages that I got from YesStyle. Thank you so much. And then we've got some eye masks in here. We've got Q-tips. We've got my Foreo. We've got a little leather pouch of just all of my hair ties. The shallow one. Woo! I feel so good after organizing it. And then we've got all of my contacts in the back. So my regular contacts that I use the AccuVue once a day. Like, I used to use the 2 weeks one, but if you have dry eyes, please make the investment in just using the dailies. It changes your life. Like, it changes my eyeball game. And then my colored contacts, I was using the Desio, which I really like those, and they're really, really pretty. So the Desio ones, I believe they're monthly contacts. So you probably use them like every day for a month is technically what they're made to be, but you shouldn't wear them every single day for a month. But I realized with those, they're not that, like, they're just not lubricating enough. Like, they're not, they're two circle lenses. They look really good on the eye. They look beautiful, and I save those for special occasions when I'm really only gonna be putting it on for like 3 hours. But when you wanna talk about like maximum eye comfort, like you can wear these color contacts all day long, but they don't give you as much color in your eye. It's gonna be these, it's the dailies. So these are once a day colored contacts, and I've got it in gray and mystic blue. I think it comes in four different colors, which is green, blue, gray, and brown. And I feel like gray is the best for light colored eyes, because I'm telling you, when I say that they don't really give you that much color, they don't really give you that much color. So you're really gonna like only see a lightning change or some sort of change in your eye color if you get gray, if you've got dark, deep brown eyeballs like I do. So I've got that, I've got my little skin roller, I've got some little creams in here, I got masks, my lotions, and then this is all my eye stuff. So I've got mascara, some brow gels, some mascaras, some eyeliners. Oh my goodness. Oh, she's still not organized, but we're trying. Also, she hit that high note really good. Okay, sorry. It just felt so much faster and quicker putting on some foundation this morning. And then we've got this drawer. It just looks so much more organized. But that's gonna be it for today's video, because they're literally installing these giant ass mirrors. We've got a workstation out front in the garage. They have like a table and they're chopping up mirror pieces. It's so confusing. But I'll see you guys in tomorrow's vlog. Say happy birthday to my fiance in the comments. Just kidding. Sorry. I don't wanna like beg for that. But like, it was his birthday.